India, you have some people that are reasonably sane. I've never thought I'd say John McCain was reasonably sane, or you know, that maybe maybe he's somebody that we ought to listen to. But he's trying to tell his rank and file that he has seen this before. He's been through this. His words were, he's seen this movie before, and it didn't end well for the Republicans. And what he was talking about was Newt Gingrich, you know, back in the 90s, where they sent a million workers home because the government shut down. Now, what we have happening here, understand, is you have the Rubio Confederation of Rand Paul, Ted, you know, Cruz, Tom Coburn, all the Confederacy of Dunces that are saying this is so important that we will shut this government down again. But then you do have it's not because these particular Republicans are so rational, but when you have Senate Minority Whip like John Cornyn saying, you know, this is a really screwball thing to do, which is to defund the government over this, because Obama's going to veto it anyway. If we did build in some defunding mechanism, Obama would veto it. And it doesn't seem to be getting across. Some people aren't getting the memo. We're still seeing them on Fox News. We're still seeing them running their mouth about this issue. And it's almost like there is complete disarray, even more so now in the Republican Party. What's your take?
Everything that you have just articulated to me refers back to the term that we hear a lot in reference to Republican regressives, and that is the Obama derangement syndrome. This is to a point where it's clearly emotional, and it's so irrational, one cannot wrap their head around it. The drumbeat of the right wing talkers and the marination of everything Obama bad and everything right wing good has really come to a head now, and I think this rhetoric yet again is going to meet reality. Everything stops at the wallet, and when one person has to pay more for health care insurance than someone else in another state, I think the reality of the wallet is going to cut through the rhetoric. And you're right. I heard what Senator McCain had to say, and I appreciated him saying it, speaking to his colleagues. Like, come on, guys, this is looking ridiculous. I'm paraphrasing.
Well, let's talk about really what. It is. It does look ridiculous. But nevertheless, you've got about. I think maybe 50 or 60 people in the House. You've got about, right over a dozen, maybe a dozen in the Senate that signed off on this absurd notion that Mike Lee from Utah has put out there, and that is this pledge to vote to defund Barack Obama's Health Care Act, regardless whether or not you can rationally argue it or not. It's like it's the same thing as these fools that sign off on this is my pledge never to raise taxes because Grover Norquist tells them that must be that's what they must do. And at some point you start saying, okay, Obama seems pretty comfortable with all this because right now he's embracing this. He's calling it his. You know, he's not used the term Obamacare, but he's gotten very close to saying, yeah, this is mine. I'm proud of it. It's going to happen. And those are very positive words because he feels very comfortable with his position here, that the Republicans really are not going to be able to accomplish what they think they can. But to me, the disconnect of reality by the Rand Pauls and the Rubios, the Ted Cruzes, the Tom Coburns, just is amazing to me. But do you think it might be that beltway syndrome where they just simply are so disconnected from the rest of the country that they talk themselves into crazy?
Absolutely. I think it is. I've used the term insular in that this is very insular and politically incestuous, if you will, in that they must talk to each other, because if you connect with people who have been monetarily savaged by someone in their family getting sick, I was just with my mother at the doctor's office yesterday and just talking to a room full of people who all know exactly what is going on. They all know the regressives are blocking their access to affordable care.
In other words, India, they're not really reacting to the television ads, the media events, the PR show, the electoral campaign that's taken place by not just obviously Republican politicians, but the billionaire inheritance babies that have fought, like the Koch brothers, that have fought this from the word go. They don't seem to be being moved by that. That's
absolutely
my take on what I'm seeing. Is that yours? Yeah.
Absolutely. And they're furious. And all this is doing, Papantonio, is ensuring that people regardless of the stipulations created to keep people from voting, people have vowed that they will meet whatever the criteria is and they will vote no matter what. And it's I don't know how they come up with this as a winning strategy, the regressives, because all they have done is they have hit a beehive with a baseball bat and people are really upset.
Well, one thing for sure, the numbers don't work for the Republicans right now. I mean, Obama does not have great poll numbers right now. He's below the 50% mark, somewhere around 46, 47% approval. But you've got a Congress that has a deplorable, their percentage of approval is around 15%. So when it comes to the bully pulpit, even though I think the power of the bully pulpit is less and less with every new president, I think he has control of this discussion right now, and I think Congress actually loses where it comes to this argument. I think really that's what McCain was trying to say. He's saying, it's time for a reality check. Yeah, we love to hear all this rhetoric, but in the end, we're going to have to live with this. India, thank you for joining me. Okay.
Well, my pleasure, and thank you for what you guys do, and thank you for Ring of Fire. It's an excellent show.
Thanks for joining me.